Welcome to this trial introduction to WinSync. First, to get access to the trial, go to this URL, wimsync.com. From there, you will see there is a link to the trial option of WinSync. If you now enter your name here, so, after clicking this, I now first enter the name of my new project. Click create. And there we have a new project available for the trial period. First, we are here at the dashboard showing what is new in the project, but let's start by going to preferences by clicking up on the right part. And then what we see first is some detailed information about where you can change password, but let's go to preferences, where you can switch to the language you like to use. English is available, of course, Danish, French, this one is Japanese, Norwegian Bokmål, Norwegian Nynorsk, Dutch, Portuguese, and also Spanish. Notice that, of course, WinSync is a web application, it has an URL. That means we can use the back button and go back to the screen we want to and use that. Now we go to Models. We click the button New Model. And first, we upload an architecture model. We can click import, or we can drag and drop from the file browser. So drag and drop, we have to enter a comment. I just write one because I want to be quick and not use too much of your time. We add another model. This one is the electrical model. And yet another one. This one is the structural model showing the frame of the building. We click submit. Now we have uploaded three models and they are processing. The two first are already imported. And now the third one too. So let's click on the 3D icon, and here we see the building in a 3D view. This works in any modern browser, and also on tablet and on modern smart devices like iPhone and Android tablets and phones. Now we have all the three models available, but we only see mostly the architecture model. We support, like you see here, clipping plans, so you can see inside the building. We click on the top line to move away that left panel so we have more room. And we click on the sink, and here on the right side we see that after clicking the I button we see the inspect button, and here we also look at the toilet and information about that. So let's take a little look at this issues function. That is quite powerful. It uses the building collaboration format. Let's create a new issue. We say change this, and as you see from earlier, we have highlighted the toilet. Det er sett som options for this issue. Vi setter due date. And there is automatically generated a screenshot, and we use the drawing tools to add some visual hints. Notice that this could also have been a photo if you was on a tablet or a phone. We submit the issue and create another one. This one on this sink. New issue. A title. And optionally some description. And here, to be very creative, we add another visual hint about what we want. In this case, it's quite obvious because the selected object is highlighted in green. And now we save that issue and submit it. So if we go to look at the issues from the top level, we see we have created these two issues. You can also see them in a table format. So let's look at one of them, just to see how it would look to somebody seeing it for the first time. Notice that the 3D view changed them, and also the selected object, the toilet, is highlighted. We go to the next issue, also click on the 3D camera, and here we see that it's the sink that's selected, and we see information about it. So we get the 3D model, and we see which issues. Here, notice it says open. We also have support for documents, so let's create a new folder. So this can be used also, if you like, independently of the 3D model. So maybe early in the project you don't have a 3D model at all. So you can add as deep a hierarchy as you want, and this of course supports version control. So let's upload the document. We select the BIMSync feature list and upload that file. We select an object, and now we click what you can see here. I clicked the wrong place, but if you open the model again, we can select an object and select the door, and also we have selected this document and now and a few windows. So now we link this document with three objects. But sort of, let's see, if you click that again, you see based on this which objects are linked to that document. And you can also do the opposite thing and click on one of the things and see here that this it has a document attached to it. If you click, we go back and see what it is. Let's take a short look at it because it's quite interesting. It's the feature list for BIMSync, and this one gets bigger and bigger because we add useful features for pressure correlation. And information about this can be found at our webpage, bimsync.com. But this is just a short intro, so more about details on our homepage and also in other videos. We support libraries. Building smart data dictionary support is there. You can create new libraries like classifications from CoBuilder, user-defined Dropbox. And we also, of course, support handling of our members. You can invite members And you can also create teams. So let's create a team. And add members to it. So this has been a short introduction to VimSync as a trial user. Hope it has been useful. Don't hesitate to contact us if you have questions. Bye.